Hello, everyone. Oh, sorry. Hello, everyone, and welcome once again to Let's Play Skyrim. Last time we cleared out Bleak Falls Barrow. That was fun and exciting. Didn't find any good enchantments. Didn't learn Soul Trap like I hoped to. Like I always hope to, right up until the moment I do. That's really the moment enchanting takes off, of course, is when you're able to fill soul gems. And prior to that, it's really, really difficult to advance the skill at all. Anyway, there's a Corindamore vein on that island, and two thistles on this one. You can see right there in the water, although I wasn't able to hit it like I had hoped. There are slaughterfish in here. Slaughterfish are annoying in that, you know, they're aquatic and they don't leave the water, but you can't really do anything underwater, so you kind of have to lure them to shore like I just did. They're not very dangerous, but we need to hunt several of them for their scales. With these in hand, I need 19 more. Let's see if we can't convince the other one to come on us. If it actually manages to shoot him, all the better. Alright. There he is, another scale. Leaves me needing 18 more. Good, good, good. And now, the back exit from Bleak Falls Barrow is up there. Here's a neat little sunken barrow that we can search right here at the lake. There are clams and some barnacles around the perimeter, as you can see. Soul gem, that's always good. I seem to remember there being a loose soul gem somewhere too, in addition to the one inside the chest. Yes, there it is. Two. An empty common and an empty petty. So not bad at all. We can swim back to the shore now. Might as well catch a dragonfly or two. Or anything. Might as well check for fish as well. There they are. And with that done, I'm going to head toward the cave you can see over here, which is South Brittleshin Pass. Now, those islands, I think, are much closer to the other shore and more properly explored when we're ranging that direction. Just trying to make sure Uthgird is with me. She can get confused when you're going over rocks and whatnot. All followers can, not just her. Say, we got something here. The wolves. She should be more than capable of
just
handling
a
this herself.
Scratch. You think I'm afraid of you? Yeah.
I love it when she gets a kill. I love it when your followers get kill cams. That's just fun.
Come on, let's see you put up a fight.
We'll search that one too. Yeah, that's the fisherman's camp. We'll hit that later. This jetty right here, dock, whatever you want to call it, it's kind of our exploration endpoint for the coast. For now, this island, I think, is closer to this shore. We'll come on out and grab a Nurn root. With that one in hand, I need 8 more. Good, good, good. We'll skip the fisherman's camp, because I'm not certain it's an island. I seem to remember it might even be connected to the other shore. There's nothing on this one. And we've more or less reached the cave I want to explore, so... See there, the path heads up from this dock. There's not really a road other than that that leads here. Other than the lake shore. Down here below the cave entrance, somewhere if I can track it down, there's another ore vein. Along with a thistle and a beehive. Another cord of vein, as you can see. She is after that fox, isn't she? Not as forgiving as I am. He just ran into the way of my pickaxe. I wasn't even trying to hunt the little fella. Oh well. We'll get on the path now. This one... kind of dead ends right here, but that just heads back to the back entrance of Bleak Falls. Shouldn't call it an entrance, it's exclusively an exit. There we have discovered South Brittleshin Pass. Take it off my list right quick.
There's a cave here. Perfect hideout for bandits, or worse.
In this case, it's worse. A few very easy skeletons. And one necromancer. But, as difficult as mages can be to kill... gotta do it. Because they're the ones that just might cough up spell tomes and soul gems. Or at least they've got a substantially higher chance of doing so than your typical bandits do. Before going inside, know that there's a silver ore vein up here. Before a steep drop-off. To the other side of the mountains. I think that's it before we start getting to other locations we aren't ready for. So let's just go plow through this one. Skeletons are trivially easy, and I should be able to... The Necromancer shouldn't be too strong yet at level 17, and ought to be able to handle it. And by me, I mostly mean Uthgard. And maybe a little help in the form of distractions. It's coming in the south entrance. You'll notice some hanging moss here that, you just can't quite reach. Does that kill you like it kills me? I wonder if we can get there. Jumping onto this brazier. It's possible. If he'll jump. Yes. Now note the frost rune on the ground there.
We've stopped. What is it? Go on ahead. I'll stand guard.
I want Uthgard to wait, because I don't want to trigger the thing. Because I don't want to set... Mostly because I don't want to send all the stuff in the room flying. So, let's grab that, and you can hit the rune with a spell from a distance, trigger it, no harm, no foul.
What? We going? Lead the way.
All right. That little room solved. Here's where the skeletons are. I can't remember if there are two or three. It's not a lot. Skeletons are easy anyway.
Damn you.
We'll grab that fly amanita. First one down. While everyone's occupied, the mine the two iron veins that are in this room. One on either side of this passage. There's number one. There's number two. Couple of fly amanitas. There's nothing in the passage.
Think I'm afraid of you?
That you need to worry about. Hope we could finish the job, since she always hesitates when they take a knee. Don't know why. Now this is an interesting little spot, because the should have brought a bow and arrow. There are garnets in the eyes of this statue. And, really anything that impacts them can shake them down. Oh, they're flawless garnets. I TCL'd that, and, well, I wonder if I can make the jump without TCLing. I'd prefer to do that. I don't really feel like leaving to get a bow and shoot the eyes down, but the spells aren't working then. Ah, no, there we go. Spells can knock him down, they just have to actually make contact. Okay, there he goes. Good. Two flawless garnets. Here's a trap chest. I'll just open and run off. Amethyst and an empty common soul gem. Good. Another fly amanita. Another fly amanita. And get ready, because the necromancer is down here.
Get ready. Trouble ahead.
No kidding. He's got one skeleton pal. I think we'll definitely do better. See, he just resurrected the body in that cage. A necromage, huh? That's definitely the highest tier wizard we've seen so far. Come on, Ithgard. Come on, everybody. Let's get started. Try to hide behind Uthgard. Play it by ear once she gets going. Looks like she's gonna go after the skeleton first. Which is a tad on the foolish side, but okay. Let's finish the skeleton off at least. This is strange. I'll take it. Obviously.
Your kind has no place here. Damn you. It's nothing.
Trying to keep her in close quarters. So she'll just keep waiting.
I'll see you both.
Enough!
I'll end your miserable life! No! I'll see you!
I will. I cannot best you.
I'll end your miserable life.
Victory is yours. I see. No! Not like this! Skyrim belongs to the Nords! Die, damn you!
That was a weird little exercise trying to get that
no more. I
finish
I
off
feel.
The beast and those healing.
You think I'm afraid of you?
But we got it done. Nice work, Uther. Very nice. Let's grab that fly on, Anita.
Let's get going.
See if I can't convince her to get out of the cage. Mostly so I can loot his body. Which has nothing. Well, those necromancer robes. 50%, 75%. That's an upgrade, so I'll put those on. Absolutely. Kidding me? Awesome. So there's no key to this cage door, so we'll just have to pick it open. You probably heard the telltale chime. Means we have cleared Brittleshin Pass. It's two separate discoverable locations. The clearable one is just listed as Brittleshin Pass without a north or south qualifier. So at least regarding North Brittleshin Pass, we find ourselves in the somewhat amusing position of having cleared a location we haven't discovered yet. There we go. Let's search the table over here. Main item of interest is the human heart, just because it's a fairly rare alchemical ingredient. Head up to this altar. We've got several things. We've read Ancestors in the Dunmer. We've read the Book of Daedra. We can search the skeleton. Steel Dagger of Embers. I think I've got fire damage already. No, I don't. Okay, good. That's something. And we've got a full soul gem. So we can do at least one little bit of enchanting. We've read the Arcturian Heresy. The Warrior's Charge is a new book. It's a conjuration skill book. Maybe the first one we've read. The Warrior's Charge, an old poem of the Red Guards. It is our first conjuration skill book. Let me take it off that list. Jog over to the free skill boosts. And take it off that as well. The star-sung, far-flung tales, wreathed in the silver of Yokuda Fair, of a warrior who arrayed in hue sails his charges through the serpent's snare, and the Lord of Runes, so bored so soon, leaves the ship for an evening's dare, perchance to wake the coiled snake to take its shirt of scales to wear, and the Lady East, who eerie beast, a sleeper or prowl, can rouse a scare, screams as her eye, a light in the sky, a worm no goodly sight can bear, and the mailed steed adjoins the deed, not to be undone from his worthy share, rides the night towards scale bright, leaving the seasoned warrior's care. Then the serpent rose and made stead to close, the targets lay plain and there, but the warrior's blade the snake unmade, and the charges wander no more, they swear. Not sure how we got better at conjuration from reading that, but hey, who am I to question providence? So we got a couple of poisons, arrows, satchel, barrel, Here's the boss chest. Ordinarily, of course, I'd save it for last, but we got more to do. Now, the Dwarven War Axe, not as good as the Dwarven Mace I have sitting at home, but better than what Uthgard's got, so I'll go ahead and give it to her. Steel Sword of Frost, Robes of Major Restoration is Restoration and Magicka Regen, which is also a new effect. So that's pretty cool.
I'm still here.
So, let's trade right quick.
What do you need to take?
I'm going to swipe the Orcish Mace and give you the Dwarven War Axe. Same damage, but it'll attack faster.
Let's go.
Always better. Let's head down this way now. There's some more skeletons in here, but nothing serious. I think she's actually shooting them right now. It's fine, but... some hanging moss there. She killed one skeleton somewhere. Not sure where. Try and track it down. One major convenience spell that I always look forward to finding and get pretty stoked when I finally do is Detect Dead. Makes finding the bodies of things that you've killed much easier. Some hanging moss there. And she just bagged the other skeleton. Thankfully it's still moving around, so it's easier to see. Main thing over here is, if you come in through the north entrance, this spell trap will fire off at you. Spell traps are powered by filled soul gems. So we can do a spot of enchanting when we get back to the cabin. How fun is that? Anyway, there's a bit more hanging moss here. I think you might be able to reach a couple of these, but with a well-timed jump. Get that one. No way to reach that one, it's too far. Might be able to get that one. I don't know. Let's see how it goes. Yes, good. Alright, so let's head out the north entrance, mainly to discover the location. There it is, North Brittleshin Pass.
Perfect hideout for bandits, or worse.
So you want to see where we emerged, we're out here to the west of Whiterun. I'll go down to link up with the main road, but I'm not going to explore in either direction yet. Instead, I'll just point out when the main road brings us back to this little path leading up to North Brittleshin Pass. Oh, I do still need a lot of large antlers. There's a deer there. I'm not sure how I'm going to get to him, though. Either one of them, actually. Probably ignore him for now. As you can see, there are a few flowers along the way. The path up to the pass is marked by a cairn stone. And here's a random encounter that I might as well go ahead and clear off my list. This one is Adventurer on the Way to Nearby Dungeon. I don't think I have the requisite persuasion.
What's a milk drinker like you doing out here? Go home to your mother.
That's not the right one. This is Taunting Adventurer. So, you can pick a fight. I'm not certain it's worth it, but... yeah, this is Taunting Adventurer. Excuse me. So now that's off the list. You shouldn't talk to me like that.
Why? What are you gonna do? Cry?
Listen, I don't want any trouble.
Gods, you're boring!
Quiet here, you won't leave me alive.
You need to do better than that.
Uthgard might not need my help with this.
Just die!
Will just destroy you.
Scratch!
Anyway, all this out here are areas I fully intend to explore later. Now that we're occupied anyway, waiting for Uthgard to do that, I might as well see if I can get a large antler or two from these deer. As long as I don't inadvertently rope in anything else. Once he gets a clear shot out past you like that, it's over.
Come on, let's see you put up a fight.
I need him to run toward the mountains instead of into the ruins. Now toward the plains. This is a smart one. Come on now. How fucking wide a berth do I have to give him? Don't worry, we'll explore all these locations you're seeing later. Including the unmarked ruins out here. Hey, that's pretty handy. Full idiot be my guest. Destruction increased to level 25. We got large antlers, and we're gonna level up. Good. So with those in hand, I need... Let me find it. Here somewhere. 15 more large antlers. At this level... 18 is a health level. I'm going to take... Alchemist 3. Potions and poisons you make are 60% stronger. That's awesome! Okay. What happened to that Nord? We just gave up? Is that what happened?
What's a milk drink? Why? What are you gonna...
Gods, you're boring!
Why? What are you gonna do?
Back off!
Cry?
Now!
I don't have to take that from you!
Based on what she's wearing... It's not worth Oh, she's after the wolves. So I don't think it's worth trying too terribly hard to antagonize her. I do want to get these deer. Because large antlers are somewhat hard to come by. And I need a lot of them. They're hard to come by in any other context than hunting deer. Each large antlered deer you kill has a 50% chance of dropping a set. Yeah, you run right up to the pass. That works. Damn it. Didn't know there was one over there. Doesn't matter. Got him. And no antlers. Two more down here. Because, naturally. Anyway, I'm noticing that extra 25% boosted magicka regen. from the necromancer robes. Hard to argue with that. Elk are definitely slower. There's no doubt in my mind. They're much, much easier to kill. No antlers, of course. I don't know how I can end up on the wrong end of 50% so often, but I do. We're less than 30 minutes in, so we haven't. It's not like we're wasting too much time doing this. Not sure where that other one went. This one's an elk. With my knowledge that they are easier to kill, I'm kind of stoked on. After this one, though. Deer, a pain in the ass. And no antlers, because of course not. I mean, why would you reward my diligent effort with the one fucking thing I'm after, killing these things? It's okay. There was one other deer. I want to see if I'm able to find it or not. Or if it's taken off. I think it's gone from the scene. Which is fine, doesn't bother me. Now, these trolling giants, I think, are actually tied to the sleeping tree camp over there, so I'll leave them be. Oh, there he is. He's already on the run. I don't care enough to fuck with him. Let's head to Anissa's cabin. We got some enchanting. It's exciting. Too bad we didn't learn Soul Trap. But that's alright. Okay, bloody rags, bucket. Should always remember to go smelt first. Oh well. No need for any of these, which is fun. Those we need. Cool. I'm gonna go hit the smelter now, so I don't forget. Nice to have another level up in the bank. Of course, it means that Uthgard got stronger, which is always good.
You're someone who can get things done. I like that.
So, 3 corn domingots leaves me needing 81 more. Six iron ingots leaves me needing 599 more. And there's a silver ingot just for giggles. Alright. Now we can offload proper-like. We've still got 30 minutes to go. We may get all the way through Dragon Rising. It's after this offload, I'm gonna hand in quests and do Dragon Rising. In case, you know, that didn't give it away, that's the upcoming order of operations. Let's get rested. Put ingredients away. Ingots go in here, as do iron ingots. And these. Amethyst, deer hide, flawless garnet, ruby, silver ingot, wolf pelts, I'll go in there. Any empty soul gems go in here. And, before I forget, I have 2 full soul gems, so I should grab 2 things to enchant. Good suit of armor is usually the best. So let's do 2 steel armors. Now here's another interesting glitch in the game. You want to do your enchanting first, because oddly enough, your experience gain per created item actually goes down as your enchanting skill gets better. Doesn't make any sense, but it's the way it is. I think Fortified Destruction is still my best one by far. Maybe not by far, but it's the best one. So let's do that. There's a rank of enchanting. Didn't get another just then. Let's learn a couple of effects. We got fire damage, which is good. And we got Restoration and Magicka Regen. Also good. Unfortunately, we did not get another rank in enchanting. Oh well. With that done, we'll put our steel armors away. I'm gonna wait a bit. Because the next thing I want to do is head to Riverwood and turn in the Golden Claw, but I don't want Riverwood to get ganked by vampires. I'll stop avoiding them and let myself travel at night once I feel strong enough to deal with them. I am nowhere near that point right now. So, time to turn in the Golden Claw. We'll get some gold for it, and we'll make friends with Lucan and Camilla. Be able to take low-value stuff from the Riverwood Trader. And just because I'm cheeky like that, I'm going to steal back the Golden Claw and hold on to it.
Heard the reforming... On guard! Vampire hunters or something. In the old fort near Riften. Might consider joining up myself.
I'm going to stop stealing arrows from guards at this point. Reason being, we're about to go do Dragon Rising, which means random dragon attacks are about to start happening.
The sooner you find the claw... Show those thieves not to steal from Luke and Valerius.
I'm going to want the guards to be able to shoot. I have the Golden Claw.
You found it? There it is! Strange. It seems smaller than I remember. Funny thing, huh? I'm going to put this back where it belongs. I'll never forget this. You've done a great thing for me and my sister.
600 gold added, Golden Claw removed, completed the Golden Claw. I have returned the Golden Claw to Lucan, who rewarded me for my effort. So there we go. You'll notice a lot of stuff in here is now free to take. Iron Helmet is still too valuable.
It means so much to us to have the claw back where it belongs. Thank you.
I'm going to steal the Golden Claw. I feel like I should have it. It's too nice. And no need to steal the Iron Mace or Steel Sword. That stuff is... Oh, that's still stealing. Interesting. Anyway, now that we're friends with them, I'll take what we can, which is going to be the minor potions, not the extra nice ones. Another batch of ingredients. Can't hurt.
Lucan, we don't sell silver buckles, do we? One of the customers was asking.
No, dear sister, we do not.
All right. Do you think maybe we should?
Dear sister, we talked about this sort of thing before. We sell dry goods. More, nothing less.
Of course, Lucan, of course. I was... Well, never mind. It's a fine day with you around.
Well, we can take all this now, which is always handy. Always good to have things to sell to the vendors. Sorry, my cell phone just started ringing. Can't stand being bothered when I'm in the middle of a recording. Should just turn the phone off, except my alchemy app is on there. Double-edged sword, that. Anyway, that's it for that, so let's go drop off all the nice stuff we just got from the Riverwood Trader. Then we are going to head back to Dragon's Reach to complete Bleak Falls Barrow. I was one of those people, you know, 10 years ago when I was an undergrad, I resisted getting a cell phone for as long as I possibly could. And the reason was I hated the idea of people expecting me to always be available at any time, anywhere, no matter what I was up to. And of course, nowadays, everybody has to own a cell phone. It's just kind of the society we live in, but goddamn, if I wasn't proven right, in that particular worry. Everyone just expects you to always pick up your phone no matter what, because they know you have it with you. It's terrible. I'm in the middle of something. So it goes. Not really sure what you can do about it. And there's all that good stuff. The golden claw, of course, goes in the cupboard with the other unique items. Don't worry, we'll be upgrading to a real house pretty soon. Just have to do Dragon Rising first. So, I think I'll be okay heading straight to Dragon's Reach. Shouldn't trigger any vampires. So when we talk to Farangar, that's gonna finish Bleak Falls Barrow and start the next quest. And then things will happen a little bit quickly. So be ready.
Fear not. Come dragon or giant, we'll be ready.
You see? The terminology is clearly First Era or even earlier. I'm convinced this is a copy of a much older text.
This is a new book. Holdings of Jarl Gjalland. It's always stealing, so I'm just going to take the opportunity to read it while they're chatting. Take it off the list. Survey of the holdings of Jarl Gjalland, as witnessed by Slafnir the Scribe, so sworn by the old gods and the new. Whiterun. The Jarl's holding with plentiful water and pasturage, home of Jorvasker, the far-famed Hall of the Companions. Rorik's Steading, a small farmstead in the western plains, grain, leather, horses. Granite Hill, three farms and an inn just north of the Falkreath. A market is held here weekly. Krolden, a spacious wooden hall and pasturage recently seized from the Reachmen. Silver and iron is tribute from the natives. Bromjunar, an old settlement much reduced from former days, lumber and stone. Korvenjund, a small fortified settlement, hides and meat. Volenrud, a fortified wooden hall near Giant's Gap, meat and worked ivory. Hilgrin's Steading, a large farmstead near the base of the Monavan, grain, mead, honey. But, as you can see, the real purpose of this book is it can teach you to read the dragon language because it's got draconic letters and then the translation thereof in normal letters. Anyway, there you go.
Perhaps dating to just after the Dragon War. If so, I could use this to cross-reference the names with other later texts.
Good. I'm glad you're making progress. My employers are anxious to have some tangible answers.
Oh, have no fear. The Jarl himself has finally taken an interest. So I'm now able to devote most of my time to this research.
Time is running, Farangar, don't forget. This isn't some theoretical question. Dragons have come back.
Yes, yes, don't worry. Although the chance to see a living dragon up close would be tremendously valuable. Now, let me show you something else I found. Very intriguing. I think your employers may be interested as well. Hmm? Bah, yes, the Jarl's protege! Back from Bleak Falls Barrow. You didn't die, it seems. Ah, the Dragon Stone of Bleak Falls Barrow. Seems you are a cut above the usual brutes the Jarl sends my way.
Completed Bleak Falls Barrow. Achievement unlocked. Bleak Falls Barrow. Dragon Rising. Talk to Jarl Balgruuf. So what about my reward?
You'll have to see the Jarl about that. Maybe his steward, Avenichi. I'm sure one of them will pay you appropriately. My associate here will be pleased to see your handiwork. She discovered its location by means she has so far declined to share with me. So your information was correct after all. And we have our friend here to thank for recovering it for us.
Bleak Falls Barrow. Farangar Secret Fire, Jarl Balgruuf's court wizard, asked me to retrieve a dragon stone from Bleak Falls Barrow, a stone tablet that he believes contains a map of ancient dragon burial sites. He hopes this will help him understand how and why dragons are returning to Tamriel. He was pleased when I returned with it, and promised that the Jarl will reward me for my efforts. Dragon Rising. I recovered the Dragonstone from Bleak Falls Barrow as the Jarl of Whiterun requested. I should speak to him about my reward.
You went into Bleak Falls Barrow and got that? Nice work. Just send me a copy when you've deciphered it.
Varengar, you need to come at once. A dragon's been sighted nearby. You should come too.
A dragon? How exciting. Where was it seen? What was it doing?
I'd take this a bit more seriously if I were you. If a dragon decides to attack Whiterun, I don't know if we can stop it. Let's go.
So, Irileth tells me you came from the Western Watchtower?
Yes, my lord.
Tell him what you told me about the dragon.
Oh, that's right. We saw it coming from the south. It was fast. Faster than anything I've ever seen.
What did it do? Is it attacking the Watchtower?
No, my lord. It was just circling overhead when I left. I never ran so fast in my life. I thought it would come after me, for sure.
Good work, son. We'll take it from here. Head down to the barracks for some food and rest. You've earned it.
Incidentally, Bleak Falls Barrow, of course, is 8 out of 75 achievements, 10%. Still not giving me so close, but I assume it's still Dragon Soul, because I haven't gotten that one yet.
Irileth, you'd better gather some guardsmen and get down there.
I've already ordered my men to muster near the main gate.
Good. Don't fail me. There's no time to stand on ceremony, my friend. I need your help again. I want you to go with Irileth and help her fight this dragon. You survived Helgen, so you have more experience with dragons than anyone else here. But I haven't forgotten the service you did for me in retrieving the Dragonstone for Faringar. As a token of my esteem, I have instructed Avanichi that you are now permitted to purchase property in the city. And please, accept this gift from my personal armory.
I should come along. I would very much like to see this dragon.
A dragon has been sighted at a watchtower near Whiterun. Jarl Balgruuf has sent me, along with his housecarl Irileth, with reinforcements. Meet Irileth near the Western Watchtower, and he gave me a steel helmet of restoration. I already know that enchanting effect, so it's kind of useless. That's alright.
No. I can't afford to risk both of you. I need you here working on ways to defend the city against these dragons.
As you command.
One last thing, Irileth. This isn't a death or glory mission. I need to know what we're dealing with.
Don't worry, my lord. I'm the very soul of caution.
Well, we might as well just hang with Irileth.
I've seen you helping the Jarl.
6 minutes left. That's not going to be enough time to do the fight. We can probably listen to Irileth's rallying speech and get to the muster point and end the video there. I think that's a pretty solid bet.
Guards in Dragon Street say you aided the Jarl. On behalf of Whiterun, I thank you.
We'll just stick with Irileth. Seems to be the easiest thing to do. At level 18, it's possible that Mirmalnir will be a blood dragon. I would still expect him to just be a standard dragon, which actually isn't that hard to deal with.
Disrespect the law, and you disrespect me.
Come to chat with an old woman, hmm? Do your good deed for the day.
You've been a good friend to me. That means something.
I spend a lot of time at the market stall so I can learn the merchant's trade. I need more experience if I'm going to run an inn someday.
Here's our crew.
Here's the situation. A dragon is attacking the Western Watchtower.
A dragon? Now we're in for it.
You heard right. I said a dragon. I don't much care where it came from or who. What the?
Asgard, how can you need a blade? You should talk to Adrian at the forge.
None of us have ever seen a dragon before or expected to face one in battle. But we are honor-bound to fight it, even if we fail. This dragon is threatening our homes, our families. Could you call yourselves Nords if you ran from this monster? Are you going to let me face this thing alone?
No, no, Halskar.
But it's more than our honor at stake here. Think of it. The first dragon seen in Skyrim since the last age. The glory of killing it is ours, if you're with me. Now, what do you say?
My friend Maven and I.
Dragon?
Have you met Maven?
Damn right.
We know our place in this world. Know the place of others, too.
All right, we got 4 minutes left. 3, 4, somewhere in that range. As I thought, that's going to be enough time to get to the Western Watchtower. It's now a marked location, so we will, of course, discover it. And then I'm going to end the video there. We'll fight the dragon, turn in the quest, and move into Bree's home. That'll probably be everything we can do in the next video. Still, it'll be nice and tidy. Then we'll have Unrelenting Force. Even the first word, just the ability to stagger an enemy, can really help with, when you've got a when my main way of killing things is via a follower. Even just knowing Foos can help a lot. Then we'll be able to unlock it after we complete that quest, so. Flowers. Take a little break to try and catch some butterflies. That one is sprinting away. Alright.
No signs of any dragon right now, but it sure looks like he's been here. I know it looks bad, but we've got to figure out what happened, and if that dragon is still skulking around somewhere. Spread out and look for survivors. We need to know what we're dealing with.
All I want to do is get close enough to discover the location, Western Watchtower, so I can take it off the list. That becomes a pretty good spot to end this video. There's Western Watchtower. It's off the list. And it's time to save and wrap things up. This has been Let's Play Skyrim. We cleared out Brittleshin Pass, made some good progress. Next time, we're going to fight our first dragon and really kick the main quest off in style. Until then, thank you very much for watching. If you enjoy my videos, please consider clicking on an ad, liking a video, sharing a video, or subscribing to the channel. Even if you don't do any of that, know that I really appreciate your viewership, and I hope you have a fantastic day. Bye-bye.